the Prince of Peace. I am your calm in the midst of a storm. I am your stability. That is why I'm not made from the tree, or I don't stem from the tree of good and evil. Good and evil talks about instability. I stem from the tree of life. Just one single thing, which is life. I am the way. I'm not saying I am the ways, because I have stability. And my children must be stable. My children must not be double-minded in their thinking. Today you must say, Lord, you are my peace. Tomorrow when a problem faces you, you must still say the same thing. Lord, you are my peace. So when you walk the godly way, the Christ-like way, with an eagle mentality, further goes on to say, look at the word walk, how many meanings it has. It also means, and these are all the Hebrew meanings of that word, it also means to behave. So if I had to read it, I would say, they shall behave and not faint. So when you start behaving, you know that you are, that's what the Bible says, examine yourself. You can examine yourself. So when the enemy comes to you and says, hey, you're not worthy to be in the presence of God. You're not worthy to be going to heaven when you die. You say, whoa. Say, no, this is what my God told me. I'm not interested in what you have to say, devil. I'm interested in what my Father has to say about me. I'm living a life for the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm covered in His righteousness. I'm living according to His way. Now you don't come and tell me that I'm not worthy. So you realize that when you have examined yourself, that you are living a Christ-like way, that you are striving to live for Jesus, that you are saying, Lord, I may have failed you in the day, but Lord, I just want to know that I'm continuing for you. Forgive me for my sins. But Lord, I want to continue for you. I don't want to dwell in sin. Like now you can't, for instance, say, Lord, forgive me for my adultery. And then tomorrow go again, commit the adultery. Lord, forgive me for the adultery. Again, Lord, what we are saying is that your heart is for Jesus. You know that, Lord, this is not what I should be doing. This is a choice that I've made, Lord, that I will behave according to your manner, your mannerisms, what your word says, I will behave. And only I can do it through grace, not about strength. But I want to know, Lord, that I'm secure that I'll meet you face to face one day, because I'm striving for your perfection. I'm striving to live like you, with an eagle mentality. Lord, I don't want to live like a turkey, always on the ground, always thinking negative, always thinking I'm not worthy, always there's no flight, there's no soaring in your kingdom. Just living the day to and fro, just behaving anyhow, just behaving like of the ground. And the ground speaks about what? Dust. Now what happens? Who eats the dust? Who eats the dust? The Bible says that the snake will eat the dust of the ground. And dust talks about what? Carnality. Talks about sin. So you say, Lord, I'm behaving in such a way where, Lord, I'm eating of your fruit of life, the fruits of the Spirit. I'm not perfect, Lord, but I'm just continuing to eat of you. And you realize that the Bible says that there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. No one can condemn you when you are in Christ Jesus. Lastly, the word walk means to depart. The word walk means to depart. That means, Lord, if you want to step up the word depart, I'll give you the word repent. And repent means to change direction. It literally means to change direction, to turn away, to change direction. So, Lord, I'm going to depart from my old ways. My old man has died. I'm now renewed in you, Christ. Now all I'm telling you is this. To renew these thoughts in your mind. To say this is what's available to you. So that you live a better life for Jesus. You live as a powerful eagle in his kingdom. And when you see yourself as an eagle, others will see you like an eagle. Others will see you as a person that's living for Jesus. You find even an eagle, he just sits majestic. They know who they are. They know the magnificence that they carry, the beauty that they carry, the presence that they carry. Creatures of power. So when you walk, you say, Lord, I'm departing from the old self. I'm renewed. I'm made whole. You've taken a broken vessel, Lord, look at what you've done to it. You've made me a powerful eagle for you. And Lord, I portray your magnificence. I portray your beauty. I portray your culture in my life. I portray your image in my life. I'm made with the image of God. People may say I'm fat. But Lord, what did you say about me? You said I'm made in your image. That's just people's opinion. But what's the fact? The fact is I'm made in your image. And you said it is good. But too often we are so quick to take on people's opinion. And sometimes someone's opinion for the day of us really messes up our mind. And the enemy knows how to use that to discourage us. But I want to tell you, press on. Press on, because why? There is an eagle in you. There is an eagle that wants to soar to another level. And when you realize that you walk, there's growth. You lead, you march, you spread, you are still. Knowing that as you walk, that you are securing him. You behave according to his mannerisms, his word. And you depart from your old ways. You realize he continues to say, when you walk, you shall not faint. There is no need for you to fall down. There is no need for you to feel tired. Because his spirit restores you. What a powerful scripture verse. We haven't even finished with the series, but I'll leave you with this. Just few thoughts. Just to realize that it's so important to walk the godly walk. And you know, sometimes we want to wait for the one moment where we decide and say, you know what, hey, I think now it's time for me to get to church now. Or it's time for me to start working for Jesus. Let me wait for that moment. But sometimes the moment does not need any flashing lights. Does not need any chills over your body. Sometimes we wait for that goosebumps to know that, hey, you know what, God is suddenly moving me now. It's not about that. It's about you realizing that I have a relationship with the heavenly God. And all I have to do is nurture that relationship and be secure in that relationship. That I have a father. And I'm a son of royalty. And I can boldly go into his presence anytime I want to. Because that's the privilege we have as his children. Heaven stops just to hear me. That's how much he loves you. Anytime, any place, anyhow, when I say anyhow, however you feel at that moment, you have the ability to go into his presence. Because he didn't just say, come inside. He took the veil that prevented you from coming to him. And he ripped it apart to say, not my children. You will not leave them outside. You come inside to my presence. Come inside, children. I want to hear. I want to hear what you have to say. So, let the walk that you have with Jesus be a prayerful walk. Be a walk where you communicate with him all the time. Talk to Jesus, because he's ever ready to listen to your heart. He's a father. Even at this time, let's close our eyes and bow our heads. Thank you for this time. Dear Jesus, I thank you for everyone that's listening. I pray, Lord my God, that you meet them at the point of their need, that you allow them to see themselves as eagles. And I give you the glory for what you will do through their lives, Jesus. Father, I pray they have a relationship with you, they fall in love with you, they get to know you more and more every day, and there is an hunger for you. I give you the highest praise in Jesus' name. Remember, the best thing we can ever do is fall in love with Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.